Okay, welcome back to Mass Effect. We're continuing on with our exploration of the ship, and we're down in engineering.
Pathfinder, making the rounds. Slumming it, huh? Want to see how the riffraff are making out?
Well, this isn't slumming it.
Hey, this is the most important part of the ship.
Whoa, don't tell me they put someone smart in charge for a change. I am at your command.
Just want to see how things are going with the ship.
I can coax more out of this baby than some might think, but we shouldn't go too far or push too hard between Nexus stops. For now. It just feels good to be stretching our wings, you know? Locked in idle too long, you start to drift. People, same as ships. Stuck on the Nexus, gotta say, I was regretting joining the initiative.
Yeah, it must have been hard.
Seems like life back there was pretty bleak.
Not gonna lie, it sucked. I tend to live the way I work. Kind of feel it, do it. Not a lot of close ties. No real sense of purpose. Figured maybe I'd find my true calling in Andromeda. Then I got here and, oops, I just made a decision there's no turning back from. I was going nuts on that station. You can't know how jazzed I was when you showed up.
Well, I'll help you find a purpose.
We're exploring this cluster, eventually the galaxy. If your purpose is here, we'll find it.
Then the question will be, what will I do with it? In the meantime, you just keep pointing this ship wherever you want it to go, and I'll make sure she can get there. Deal?
Deal.
Long time no chat. What's up?
No, the Tempest.
I hear we have you to thank for getting the Tempest space ready so quickly.
Vetra brings her impossible feats to me. I was itching to get this particular call. Capital R, ready. Don't tell her, but the truth is, I fudge reports to come in early, then bust ass in secret to make up for it. Expands the Gil legend. Plus, I convey calm and assurance, and the whole team relaxes, which helps them do their jobs better.
Friends.
What's your social circle like?
I'm good for a laugh, so I know lots of people, but I don't let too many in. My one true friend is stationed on the Nexus. She's the only piece of the Milky Way I brought with me. The more you and I get to know each other, the more you'll probably hear about her.
And the Nexus.
How tough has it been on the Nexus all these months?
Have you ever eaten overcooked space cow tongue?
No.
Can't say I have.
Well, let me tell you, it's tough. Wondering if you're gonna die from a critical malfunction, or maybe starvation? Imagining which would be worse? But hey! You could always take a break from the fear and boredom to dwell on being a part of the biggest failure in galactic history. Maybe even participate in a revolt.
What was your take on that?
I didn't place any bets, if that's what you're asking. Truth is, I don't think anyone made out particularly well. Whatever side you're on, you die a little when your brother, your teammate, becomes an enemy. We traveled all this way, all hope and wonder, and we end up fighting with each other over scraps. It's sad.
And our crew.
Seems like we have a good group here.
Well, Vetra and Suvi are my girls. Get along well. Lots of mutual respect. As far as your Hyperion peeps go, Doc's kinda nosy. Liam's good for a laugh or two. Cora, she's a bit by the book for me.
Yeah, we kinda need that.
By the book keeps us alive.
Hey, variety's the spice of life, right? Different strokes makes for healthy debate.
What about Callow?
He's a pilot.
Which means...
he flies the ship.
We're leaving it at that, then?
Does a Pathfinder know what to do with a dead end?
Well, okay, talk to you later, then.
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
Alright, let's scan the, engine. Alright. Scan complete. ODS-wide drive core. Ithaca variation registration. Survey ship Tempest 2527. Current functionality optimal. The Tempest drive core is designed for long distance operation. Maximizes thrust efficiency. Okay. Anything else? What, nothing about the couplings? Oh. No relevant data. Lights it up, but it doesn't say anything. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, ladders. Look at that. It's going down. And we'll go through these doors over here. Oh, what's this? The med bay.
You're not Harry.
The blue give it away? Habitat 7 was a little more action-packed than Harry bargained for. He decided to spend his retirement years on the Hyperion looking after your sister.
What a smart move.
You know Sarah's the good one.
I think you're both trouble. Hold still.
Ow!
Sorry.
I remember you having a gentler touch.
Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
You'll be great.
I couldn't be in better hands.
I just stabbed you.
We all have off days.
I always hoped to work in the field, but everything's happening so quickly.
Focus on the positive. It helps.
I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Ket specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
What?
A Ket corpse. For autopsy, a live subject would be better, but I'm not greedy.
Why do you care about the Ket?
Harry didn't tell you. I'm a specialist in alien anatomy. My thesis on Krogan virility and aggression is what got me in the initiative.
Oh, you're full of surprises.
I had no idea. I'd love to hear more. Over dinner, maybe?
Oh. Thing is, Ryder, you're not my type.
What's your type?
Not a patient. I need to be able to look at you clinically, without distractions.
Am I distracting?
Not nearly as much as you think you are. But we were discussing the Ket. An autopsy could teach us potential weaknesses, average lifespan...
Right.
Just something to think about. Sam, make sure the Pathfinder eats his vegetables.
Okay. Nothing here. And there's the data pad. You got this. You don't need an old man. You don't need an old man a few hundred years your junior to tell you you're ready for this. I'll do it anyway because I know it's true. You keep your writers safe and I'll do the same with mine, Harry. Okay. Talk to, what's this? Respec station. Writer. Choosing to spend credits will refund writer's skills. Each successive use of the respec station will increase the cost. So I can do them all, huh? That's the respec station. Right, talk to Luxie again.
Feeling okay?
Memory fragments.
I need to talk to you about something private.
Of course. That's what I'm here for.
When Dad died, he blocked off parts of Sam's memory. Things he didn't want me to see.
Or he thought you weren't ready for.
Maybe. I found this... trigger? It unlocked a... memory fragment of Dad on the Citadel. From when the Alliance rejected his ideas about AI, and he found out Mom's illness was terminal.
Why do you think your father chose this specific memory?
It was a turning point.
It was where his journey to Andromeda really began.
Those events started your family down a new path.
Yeah. Thanks, Lexi. Feels good to talk about this.
Okay. Joining the Hyperion.
So, how did an Asari doctor end up on the human Ark?
Specialist in alien anatomy, remember? That includes humans. Also, Harry insisted. Maybe he always intended to switch jobs.
Oh, friendship with Harry.
How long have you and Harry been friends?
I remember when he didn't complain about arthritis. We met at a medical convention on the Citadel. He was moderating a panel on neurosurgery in low-gravity environments. His name card was crooked, but he was so damn confident, I knew we'd be friends.
All right, see you around.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
What's this, crew quarters?
Most of the crew bunks in here. Cozy, huh? But your room's got more of a view.
Oh, okay, the crew info board. What's that? Dinner tonight, null entry. Sorry, everyone, I forgot. We were taking turns on half the rations aren't unpacked yet. Kello. Comments. Got you covered, Kello. There's soup in the galley, dextro and levo for me, and fruit cocktail, Vetra. And to think we might have left port without you, Kello. Anyone want help to move a couch? Not right now, but I'll keep you on my list, especially if you're biotic and can drop the weight. Pay you back in beer or whatever else we find, Liam. Comments. Are you serious, Suey? I never joke about comfortable seating, Liam. Welcome to your new info board. Congratulations, Pathfinder writer, on successful installation of your info board of version 3.4. You are now ready to keep yourself and your staff informed on the latest developments aboard the Tempest. Aboard the Tempest. Info board number 6. Comments. Okay, I've set up everyone user accounts. Have at it, Cora. So we can post anything here, Liam? Anything you want the whole crew to see, though I disabled image embedding, Cora. Missed opportunities, Liam. Liam's a strange one. All right. And that's about everything there. Nothing else to scan. And we'll go over here. What's this? Oh, the galley. I guess this is where everybody gets their food. There's only like... Well, I guess everybody can sit there. And they got the restroom, and it's just a neutral gender restroom. Okay. Ah, and this must be the...
These are the Pathfinder's quarters.
Pathfinder's
Your quarters. Sam's router is down there, too.
Oh, look at that. Clothing and armor customization. Check the wardrobe screen in your quarters to change your casual outfit. Customize your armor. Okay, that's nice. Alrighty. What's this? Can I push any buttons here? Nope. View over there. Bunch of lights. Oh, what's that? Wardrobe customization. Alright, casual outfit. Jacket. You can go with the jacket, short sleeves, or the long sleeves. We'll go with a jacket. And then the armor. Default tints. Auto tint. What's auto tint? Custom tents. That's the custom tents, huh? What's this? It's default custom tents. Customize the color. Color 1. Okay, we'll go with that. Go on number 3. Okay, pattern selection. Let's go with that. All right, outfit color one. Okay, color two again. Color three. About right. Okay, we'll go with that. Pattern color. Pattern select. Okay, there we go. Then, jacket. Customize the colors. That's good. Looks pretty decent. Alright, now we're back. That's decent enough? Okay. Alright, and now what else is in here? Ah, we got an email terminal. Interviews. To writer from Carrie Tavess. Hello, Pathfinder. I'm a freelance vid maker. And I could really use your help with my latest project. It's going to be historic. I hope just like your mission. Can we meet on the Nexus for a chat? I can explain better in person. Carrie Tavess. All right, we'll acknowledge that. Reminder to writer from Cora. Thanks for talking. Things feel better, though they don't feel fixed yet. Remember to take time for yourself, too. Work's important, but so is time to grieve. Grief and fear cannot rule you. Let them be your faithful servants, protective of their mistress. Loss serves a huntress like fuel serves fire. Estheris, 12 leaves, verse 132. Cora, P.S. Plants are coming along. Sam and I are learning about botany together. Interesting times. Proud to be here. To writer from Liam. Hey, Pathfinder, just hitting this point again. Our team, no place I'd rather be. Here's where we get to fix things. Soon as we have people on the ground, I'll have eyes on how to get them what they need. This sort of just make it happen is why I joined Hustle and exactly why I'm here, came here. We'll do it, Costa. Liam has included a list of media themed and two frontiers. Genres include Western, space opera, and oddly, Turian historical dramas. Like Shakespeare, Turian Shakespeare. They never mention that too much, do they? You're the boss, to writer from Vetra. Pathfinder, I thought I ought to clarify. I know I said something about back channels. Doing what I have to do, being on the Nexus during the bad times, a lot of us used to do a lot of ugly things because survival just isn't that pretty. But in the end, I'm here to help you. So if there's anything you don't like, I won't do it. Simple as that, Vetra. In case you're interested, writer from Lexi, attachment, Krogan virility and aggression. Writer attachment is my Krogan thesis that I mentioned to you. I know only 500 pages, but I wasn't allowed to go over. If you get through it, I wrote a longer dissertation for the Citadel Journal of Medicine, around 1,400 pages. That's much more insightful and includes mating diagrams. Lexi. Okay, I don't think we want that. Okay, that's it. Archive. All right, exit. Oh, what's this? SpaceX rocket model. All right, and hey, we got the one model right there. Guess we just go wandering around finding these models. Okay, talk to Sam.
Hello, Ryder. It is interesting to be renewed.
How do you mean?
Since my creation, I have been Alec Ryder's Sam. Now, I am your Sam. I am still myself, but now the input and experiences I have are completely new. I will develop in a new direction. The term reincarnation seems appropriate.
How do you feel about that?
Are you okay with changing who you're becoming?
I cannot know until I see the result. I look forward to our continued partnership.
Memory triggers.
Sam, any more information on the memory trigger we found?
The memory blocks are still in place. If you continue searching for more triggers, they may unlock.
Sam's location.
Are you still on the Hyperion?
Yes. This terminal provides a direct link to my servers in SamNode on the Ark. I can maintain a presence on the Tempest via quantum entanglement communication.
Quantum what?
Let's say, hypothetically, I was out sick the day they taught quantum embezzlement communism.
Via entangled subatomic particles, it's possible to conduct secure and instantaneous communication across great distances. It ensures I remain in touch with you and the Pathfinder team at all times.
Great. Sarah and I.
What was Dad's take on me and Sarah?
He believed your family trials brought you closer together, and hoped that would endure. It appears that hope was well-founded.
Okay, humor.
So if we're going to work together, you might notice I like to joke around sometimes. Lighten things up. How's your sense of humor, Sam?
Alec Ryder encouraged me to develop this skill.
Humor's not a skill, it's... Okay, try telling me a joke.
A neutron enters a bar and asks, "How much is a drink?" The bartender replies, "For you, no charge."
I can see why Dad told you to keep working on your humor.
Log off.
Thanks, Sam. Nothing more.
It's just too crazy, huh? And back up the ladder. They need like a chute on the ship. Like play chutes and ladders. Alright, nothing else there. Well, let's see if anything changed with this. Because I would like that helmet there. Oh, there it is. Titanium, right there. Alright. Can I get 10 pieces of that? Oh, 4-4. Oh, I need 40 more. Let's see. 3 of those. Let's see here. Immediately reloads all weapons, recharges all powers, and temporarily boosts accuracy and damage reduction. Okay, maybe we want to keep that for a bit. Find something else. Metagel canisters. Nope. Shotgun receiver. Like that. Okay, we'll sell this one. Oops. Alright. Oh, 39. I gotta sell one more thing. Alright, so one of these. And do it again. All right, there we go. Now we got the titanium that we need. All right, confirm the trade. All right. Develop. Okay, armor. Helmet. Here we go. Pathfinder helmet. We got a required. Oh, that's required materials. But how do we get into the? Oh, I don't have anything like that. Okay, let's do this. Let's craft it. Continue. All right. All right, now we're going to go to our loadout station. That's a letter. Okay. And that's probably how you, the airlock. That's how you get out of there. Okay. So I looked around here, didn't find much except for the loadout station. And now we'll change the helmet. Because, see, we lost our helmet originally, so I'm just trying to match them up with what the story should be, because we don't have that helmet anymore. That helmet's gone. We should have this helmet. A Pathfinder helmet. Okay, there we go. Alright. And mods. Can I put any mods on this? No mods. There we go. Loadout. Oh, can I do weapons? No, I already got the weapons. Okay. Okay, there we go. Back over here. Sell that element. No, not that. I thought I had a helmet. Sell that one. Yeah. We don't have that helmet. We lost that one a long time ago. Okay. Now we're here. Talk to Suvi.
Ah, Pathfinder. It's so wonderful to meet you. I'm Dr. Suvi Anwar, assigned to act as liaison between your crew and the Nexus Science team.
Well, welcome aboard.
Welcome to my team. I look forward to working with you.
Likewise. I can't wait to get to work. There hasn't been much to do so far, unfortunately. I've studied all the planetary scans. I've even had some hands-on experience with Helios soil samples. If you want, I'll send you my analysis on the native bacteria and microfauna. 60 pages.
Oh, that's long.
That's a lot of pages. About dirt.
Oh, you don't have to be kind. I know it's barely more than a summary. Anyway, I've waited months to get out there to see Helios. It's why I joined the initiative. The Milky Way was just a corner of a vast universe, a corner of a tiny corner. We're the ones who got to step out of that corner. It's incredible.
I guarded a mass relay for some time. I always wanted to see the other side.
I totally know what you mean.
So will you be joining us on missions?
Oh, that's funny. Me, out there, with the guns and the danger and everything.
Oh, I could show you.
I'm good with guns and danger. I could teach you. And make sure you're okay out there.
I appreciate the offer, but I'm happy where I am. Tinkering in labs. And, in case you offered hoping to get to know me better, that's not gonna work. I mean, I prefer to keep things professional.
I understand completely.
Anyway, I've just received some instructions from the science team, and I really should go over them. Later, then.
Huh. Guess we got the wrong conversation going on there. Alright, let's talk to Kalo.
Glad you stopped by. You'll pardon me if I keep an eye on our vector.
That's probably smart.
Nothing like being on the bridge of your very own ship, is there?
You said you designed it.
You mentioned something about helping design the Tempest?
Test pilot, mostly. Plunging through the Nemean Abyss was almost a preparation for the Scourge. Of course, it took a whole team to build the Tempest. I was the only one to come to Helios, though.
Why did you?
What can I say? We poured our hearts into a ship that wouldn't realize her potential until Andromeda. I could have stood on the shore and waved goodbye, or took the leap to see how it all turned out.
Well, I've done the same.
I get it. Like leaving a good story half finished.
The team liked that one of us was going. It felt right after all we went through. I remember Serena debugging line 2281 over and over, chewing that green pencil. Tion and O'Connell arguing equations, tapping on the console, 3 drips of coffee on the corner.
You remember all that?
Hmm? Oh, yes. Solarians have photographic memories, and apparently mine's unusually sharp. Like my past is still happening. Though I suppose with the Solarian arc missing, you might not get many chances to compare.
Any word on the Solarian arc?
Did you hear anything about the arc back in the Nexus?
Not a peep. Isn't that strange? You'd think there'd be something. Not that I dislike your company, but it's lonely without other Solarians.
Well, there's always Tan.
Cheer up, Callow. We'll always have Director Tan.
That snide little bureaucrat? All the more reason to find the others. I should get back to it, but thank you. I was afraid the Tempest would be mothballed after we lost your father. We built her for this. She deserves to be in a Pathfinder's hands. Please, come by any time.
Okay, great. Okay, so I guess that's the ship. So now that we know about the ship, we got to do our missions. Task: Path of a Hero. Okay, Nexus. Station name, Nexus. 15.47 kilometers when completed. Anchorage wheel diameter 5.3 kilometers. Status: under construction. Docking bay. Okay, let's get out of here. Let's exit. Exit again. Wait. Oh, I've got to hold it down. Okay. Oops. Use the galaxy map again. Okay. System view. Okay, let's go with that.
Anomaly on sensors.
Oh, really? Already? So I'm right there. Ah, over here somewhere.
Deploying probe. Getting a scan.
Element zero. Let's go get that element. There it is, element zero. I'm just floating out there. Okay. Element zero, an unusually rich deposit of element zero. This appears to be a primary source broken up by space-time distortions in this scourge. Alright. Okay, so we don't have anything else around here, do we? No. Oh, that's it. But we should check out these planets. These time distortions. Nothing on the moon? Okay. Well, that was nothing. So where are we going now? That's the Nexus over there. And then H599.
Something.
What is that? It's wreckage.
Detecting what's left of a ship.
Ship ident, Nexus 4623. Ship name, Caryatid. Crew complement, 5. Reported missing, presumed loss. The Caryatid is heavily damaged and adrift, but salvageable. It can be salvaged. So we got all sorts of devices off of that. That's it. Nothing else. Oh, we got 2 planets already. Let's go to this one. Gong Zen. That's a nice black hole in the background right there. Pretty big. Gong Zen. Okay, nothing on that one. And this is Fizen.
Anomaly on sensors.
Gonna find out what's over here.
Probes launched.
Launch.
Anomaly found.
A volcano. Great. XP. That's all we got for that one. Orbital distance, 1.3 AU, orbital period, 0.8 years, radius, 9,315 kilometers, atmospheric pressure, 6.07 atmospheres, surface temperature, 1,303 C, analysis, Fizen is extremely hot and volcanic activity world. A thick carbon dioxide and ethane atmosphere covers an iron-rich surface with deposits of calcium. All right. Okay, now we're in the Helios cluster. Well, that's not the center of the Andromeda galaxy. It's probably just the center of the Helios cluster. All right. Well, should we go to Eos? What's this one? Pfeiffer? We can scan these places, but let's first go to Eos. Start the next part of the mission.
System Pythias, Andromeda Initiative Habitat 1, designated Eos.
It was supposed to be an easy first step, until no one else showed and we got clobbered. Twice.
Why has Sam altered frequency detection?
What are we hearing, Sam?
There is a signal, Pathfinder. I recommend an immediate examination of Eos.
Huh. We'll do that after I get this anomaly here.
Probe away. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
What kind of huge mineral deposit have we got? Check out this system. See what we got here. Big asteroid. Iron deposit. This off a big giant meteorite. Alright, let's go over here. Nanook. Of the north. it's to the west. Well, we won't go to that. Okay. And we scan this planet, and nothing. Alright. Head down to... Oh, you know what? I forgot to see what this planet's all about. Alright. Nanook is a hydrogen methane gas giant. Debris is in its orbit, suggests it has seen Ket visitors. Okay, Ket have been here. And H-060. I guess the H is for Helios, the 60th planet located in the Helios cluster. Until somebody names it. Well, nothing. Orbital distance, okay. Nelson's H-60 has its satellites attract debris from Pythias asteroid belt, resulting in multiple dust rings. Numerous meteorite impacts have left H-60 rich in nickel, but these same impacts make mining difficult. Okay, that's why we're not mining it. Okay, we're gonna go to Pillay. Heading to Pillay. There's Pillay. Okay, analysis. Tidal heating and bombardment from Pythias asteroid belt has aggravated Pillay's volcanic activity. Methane is in the upper atmosphere, contributes to the planet's scorching conditions. So it's a really hot planet. Okay. In our next world, we'll go over to Khonsu. Maybe they got some Khonsu commands. Alright. Here we go. Right on into this place over here. And we'll check this one out. Do some more scanning.
I'm picking up something.
Alrighty. Right about here somewhere.
Deploying probe. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Beryllium deposit. A few more of these and we can make a beryllium sphere. Alright. Analysis. A metal ideal for lightweight construction, variety of applications. Okay, analysis. Khonsu's oddly mild climate, given its orbital distance and rich resources, made it a candidate for a mining outpost. However, its unexpectedly rugged terrain has tabled discussions indefinitely. Guess it's too rugged, huh? Okay. And we'll go to this last place up here. H-276.
Something.
Okay. Well, analysis. Remote and cold H-276 is nevertheless of interest due to phosgene gas in its thick chlorine atmosphere. This could indicate primitive chlorine-based life. However, no detailed study has been completed. Well, if it's chlorine and ammonia atmosphere, you could probably end up with Volus.
Probe away. Satellite detected.
All right, check out the satellite. 50 Milky Way research data for finding the satellite. A scientific monitoring satellite launched by early explorers into Eos. Its mission was abandoned when the original settlement of Eos failed, but it has gathered valuable data from H-276. Okay, just a satellite. All right, now we're going to Eos. There we go. Eos. Oh, I guess the very first of the game was Habitat 7, not Eos. I have to correct that. This is Eos. This is Habitat 1.
A signal on Habitat 7. Possible atmospheric manipulation.
Is that possible?
We'll find out. If it is like Habitat 7, no doubt we'll run into the cat.
A desert world with significant resources, Eos is often racked by deadly radiation-contaminated storms, cataloged as non-viable after numerous attempts to settle. Signal detected similar to the devices on Habitat 7. Alright, we're going this way. So this is Eos. Oh, landing zone has been found. Available minerals. A better beginning and... first murderer. Do you wish to disembark the Tempest? Yes, let's do it. And there we are. We're going down. Okay. Well, we don't have... well, yeah, we do have a pistol. Nope. We don't have a pistol. That's it. We're ready to go. Armor's ready. Okay. Inferno. Okay, Inferno ammo. Alright. And, we got Liam and Cora. Question mark, unavailable. Okay, confirm the loadout. There we go.
Suiting up.
Ready, Freddy?
Hope we're all that ready. Callow. Alright.
Integrating search area from Sam. How he pulled that mystery signal through the storms, I have no idea.
Multisensory neural collision. Amazing.
Factory fresh across the board. Spinning up the compensators.
You're already tuning the displays.
We'll get a better read on this pass than the Nexus has had in months.
What?
I said a lot of people have their hopes pinned on us. They gave up on Eos. Can't blame them. Expected a golden world, instead they saw their friends die. Never know how that'll affect. Sorry. You okay?
Well, the uncertainty ends with us.
We didn't come millions of light years to die in a different place. I'm not letting the initiative down.
Pathfinder? The Tempest checks out. We're good.
Okay.
Take us down.
You have no idea how long I've wanted a Pathfinder to say that.
Core is hot.
Shields holding, adjusting entry.
We got this, right?
Hell.
There we go.
There. Set us down at this nav point.
Alright, well, we landed on Eos.
How to even start?
Reports state this planet suffers deadly storms that are contaminated by radiation from the Scourge. Eos deployment was incomplete due to environmental hazards and, ultimately, hostile encounters.
Plus, no Pathfinder. If Eos is like Habitat 7, that signal we scanned must be connected with the atmosphere. We could use the outpost's antenna to track it down. Let's get the power back on. They must have known these wouldn't last in these conditions.
They didn't have a Pathfinder.
They do now. We'll make Eos a home.
Okay, so that ends this episode. And we'll come back and explore Eos.